I sent my keyboard to a6d. If you know me, you probably already know about my keyboard. It isn't the cleanest keyboard, but it works. I have been using this keyboard for as long as I can remember. I've tried cleaning it, but let's be honest, it barely did anything. In this video, I will tell you the story about this keyboard. Trust me, it's more interesting than you would expect. By the way, as of right now, I only have about 340 subscribers on YouTube. That's absolutely insane to me, but obviously, seeing all these big YouTubers with all their thousands of subscribers is inspiring to me. Because of that, I'm starting to put more effort into my videos. I want to be part of the club, so I would really appreciate it if you subscribed. You can always unsubscribe later. I'm also doing a giveaway on my Twitter, the link for that is in the description. Honestly, the reason why I never switched is because I never saw the need to. It still works completely fine, and cleaning is something I can just do myself, no need to buy a new one. Imagine your car gets some dirt on it, you wouldn't buy a whole new car. You would clean it off. I thought the same about my keyboard, but for some reason I always put off cleaning it. Obviously, after a while I started nosing and it got pretty bad. I think this was around 2017, because that's the earliest photo I could find of it. At this point, it was just a funny meme to me. In reality, I don't think this picture accurately shows how dirty it was. I noticed that if I turn on the flash on my camera, it looks way worse. So every time I took a picture of it, it was with the flash. Later in 2019, I actually did consider cleaning it. But then came the problem, how? Keep in mind, this keyboard was released in 2005. This is a membrane keyboard, not a mechanical one. And it isn't even a USB. Can I take off the keys? I don't know. I definitely didn't want to try and risk ruining it. So I just used wet wipes instead. Yeah, I'm not fooling anyone with that. It barely did anything. To be honest, I also haven't really looked into ways of cleaning a keyboard. At this point, the keyboard was already a bit of a meme, and I didn't want to ruin that. My friends made a few jokes about it, and even Bad Boy Halo joked about it to me. Here's a drawing he made about a year ago. Bad did send me a video about how you can clean membrane keyboards in the dishwasher. It's a video by Linus Tech Tips, and I recommend you give it a watch. I didn't do it though. I am a pussy and I was too scared to try it. This was mainly because I couldn't really tell if the video was completely serious or not, so I decided not to do it. I'm also scared of having to learn to use another keyboard. Last year, my old mouse broke. I got it in 2015 from a grocery store. I really liked it, but at some point it didn't click anymore and I was forced to switch. I switched to a Logitech mouse. It feels more accurate, but I don't feel like I perform better in games. If I'm honest, I'm pretty sure I even had mouse acceleration enabled on my old one. On my birthday, a6d surprised me with an Amazon gift card, so I could get a new keyboard. I am really thankful for that, and make sure to send him some love because he really didn't have to do that. As stubborn as I am though, I started looking for ones that are the most similar to my original keyboard. I found one and I bought it. Then, a few hours later, I realized that it was a keyboard with a German layout, which means that some of the keys are in a different place. I immediately cancelled the order and got this instead. This is a V7 keyboard, or at least that's what it says in the Amazon description. I have absolutely no idea if V7 is the brand name or the model number. I don't know anything else about this keyboard, but I've used it for a while now and honestly, it's horrible. If you want to get a keyboard, do research. I am writing the script for this video on the V7 keyboard right now. And it's really not fun to use. The shift and spacebar keys squeak sometimes and it really hurts my ears. The keys are also super hard to press, especially the backspace key. Legit, look at this and just listen to the sound. It's horrible. I can only really press it if I'm right in the middle of the key. If anyone knows a good fix for this, please let me know in the comments. After using the V7 keyboard, I switched back to my disgusting old one. I felt really bad about it, but a6d didn't give up there. He messaged me and said, "Send me your keyboard and I'll clean it and send it back." I replied, "Sure," but in reality, I wasn't sure at all. First of all, at the moment, that's the only keyboard that I like. I'll be forced to get used to a new one. And it also has quite a bit of history, for me at least. Most of the typing that I've done in my life has been on that keyboard. It was a difficult decision for me, but in the end, I did send it. And I recorded this video on the way to the postal office. Yeah, I'm on my way to the postal office.
A6d could probably just take the DNA from my keyboard and clone me.
If you see someone who looks like me and speaks French, let me know. Because blame A6d for that.
He could probably legit like take my DNA from it.
I'm almost there, by the way. I actually have never sent a package before. So I don't have anything on here and I'm just gonna ask him like, "Hey, how do you do this?" Because I don't know.
So there it went. I shipped it off and it's now on its way to France. Right now, I'm writing the script for this video on the V7 keyboard. It's the only keyboard that I currently have after all. I don't like it, but I'm getting used to it. One thing I do like about the new V7 keyboard though, is that it completely got rid of my fear of having to change keyboard. I really don't think it can get any worse than this keyboard. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and follow me on Twitter. Once this video goes up, I'll be doing a giveaway on my Twitter for a month of Discord Nitro. Also, please leave a like and comment on this video. Any interaction with this video helps me, especially feedback, so please let me know what you think of this. For now, I think that's it. If something interesting happens, I'll probably make a new video about it. Thank you so much if you made it to the end. Again, please leave feedback in the comments. Have a good day, and I'll hopefully see you later.